ready to attack. We were totally unprepared, and when the bees bombarded us, we could not gather enough thoughts to fight back. It was a normal day when the bees struck. We were having a normal science class, heading into the woods to study fungi. I was one of the first men to cross enemy lines with a stone wall, which were heavily fortified with defense areas. We were studying their plant life, looking for fungi. All was going well in his plant when a friend would yell, "Bees!" Panic rose over me, but luckily my instincts kicked in, and I ran and ran and I ran until I knew that the bees would forget me and go for the more vulnerable members of my squad. I waited for my leader, who luckily wasn't stumped, to retreat back to me. About half the squad was still out in the battlefield, retreating as far as the other side of the field. Many people had left their gear that they needed for later missions. My leader asked if there were any volunteers to retrieve any lost gear. I was one of the few people to volunteer. I needed to move quickly and stealthily. There was a notebook near the basketball landmark. I went in and retrieved it before I was noticed. I scanned my surroundings and found a tactical shoe piece. As I moved in to grab the object, an attack unit spotted me and moved in. I moved quickly, dodging its strikes. Finally, it pulled back, and I retreated back to my now slightly bigger squad. We entered the building, and I was shocked at how many Army members were injured. There was a whole makeshift hospital for the victims of the attack. I walked into one chamber of the hospital, and there was screaming and crying. Next thing I knew, a nurse walked up and told me, "Get out!" Some squad members were permanently damaged, and the battle will go down in school history. Now we're all veterans of the Beetle Field. I'm sure we'll all keep moving on in the science industry, or at least just ask a question every now and then. I think the best thing we got out of that experience was a good story to tell. Thank you, Cole. I would now like to invite Superintendent Ekstrom to the stage to present the Superintendent's Award.
Mr. Thompson, I just think you're slacking on one thing.
Fifth grade?
Recognition ceremony. It is great to be here today as your superintendent of schools. As of this moment, our fifth graders will officially begin their transition from being an elementary student to becoming a middle school representative at Tohonto. It has been a joy watching you and experiencing the elementary school over the last 4 years. When I began working here at Berlin Boylston Public Schools, you were all in the second grade. But now I get to watch you all become teenagers. We're gonna have fun, I think. And I have to tell you, you've already left an impression with some of your teachers. Just like we heard how the teachers left an impression on you. In fact, here's what some of them had to say. Miss Inwood, she actually explained, this graduating class has a lot of personality. And Juan was all in caps, by the way. I love each of them, and they are unique and passionate about so many different things. I know that in this group, we have future artists, entrepreneurs, and educators, just to name a few. My advice to them would be to embrace that which makes them special, as we need all types to make the world a better place. Mrs. Koziak said, this is a group of, a good group of diverse students that complement each other. Mrs. DeFonso, she stated, this group is a special one. When I think about them, I will always remember how they cared about one another, stood up for one another, and accepted one another for all of their differences, whether it be academic or behavioral or any other means. They embraced each day with a positive attitude and were not easily fazed I'm going to miss this crowd. Then I asked Mr. Thompson, and as your principal, he said, I think of their sense of humor. When I think of this group, they have a good sense of community too, and they are able to laugh together. Some of you may be excited about going to Tohonto next year, and some of you may be nervous. Regardless of your feelings, keep this in mind. As you grow through your teenage years, you will make mistakes. You will make wrong decisions from time to time, and you will have situations that you may even need to apologize for. But mistakes are okay, as long as you learn from those mistakes to make yourself a better person. You should reflect on how you can make a bad situation better, and you need to allow all of those who care about you, your family, your friends, your teachers, principals, and yes, me, your superintendent, because I care about you too. You need to allow us to teach you when you make those mistakes, but also take in the compliments and be proud that you've achieved your goals. Not only do I want to stand here today congratulating you for moving into the middle school, but I also want to thank you as well. You see, my happiest days are walking into your classes and seeing the spark in your eyes when you learn something. You don't realize that happens, but I do. I enjoy watching you become the wonderful young adults who represent our school, not just here, but publicly. You might learn from your teachers, but what you don't realize is we're learning from you too. My favorite days this year at Boylston Elementary School was being a part of your tricycle race, watching you perform at the memorial celebration, and also coming into your classes to talk about a very interesting place. What did I talk to you about? China, that's right. Shanghai. Although you will leave here with memories, I will also always cherish the memories you have provided me. So I wish you the best of luck as you move into middle school, and I look forward to seeing you at Tohonto next year. So congratulations to the class of 2000, the fifth grade class of 2016, and our future high school graduating class of 2023. Superintendent's Award. Each year, MASS, which is the Massachusetts Association of School Superintendents, allow all of the superintendents to honor somebody at graduation in 12th grade for the Superintendent's Award. We take it a step further here. We do it in 5th grade as well as 8th grade. So I'd like to now describe this individual. This student is one that stands out among his peers. He's a polite young man that has earned the respect of his teachers, classmates, and friends. He is hardworking, responsible, and meets a challenge head on. While he's a great student, he's also one who knows how to have fun. He has a great sense of humor and a very upbeat, positive attitude. Not only is he respectful and courteous, but he is empathetic and caring. This year's Superintendent's Award goes to Wesley Hayes. Thank you.
I have sensational memories here.
The most strong ones are like the first day of kindergarten and meeting friends, which most I still have. I also really like the field trips we took. Another thing I admire is the extra activities we do, like the Race for Education, Field Day, the Tricycle Race, and the Student versus Teachers basketball game. Let's start with my first year besides preschool, kindergarten. Zoom.
Mom, look, I'm a big kid.
That's right, a big kid. Kindergarten is what I call the big kid years, even though half the day was playing nonstop. My terrific teacher was Mrs. Pasqual. Her aide was Mrs. Starris, and I, for sure, will never forget them. The parts that make kindergarten memorable were mostly our teachers, the huge skylight, and keeping the chicks. How could I forget those cute little fuzzballs? My very first field trip was at the apple orchard. I can't lie, that was very exciting. I ate all the apples I picked, and I almost threw up. Another thing that was exciting was my first year of computer lab, art, gym, music, and library, even though I couldn't read. That's what made next year sound intriguing. Fascinating first grade. It was fantastic because we learned to read. My teacher was Mrs. Jagir, and her aide was also Mrs. Jagir, which is very confusing. We learned to add, subtract, write stories, and study social studies, like the continents and where China is. Our field trip was at Tower Hill, and I remember all my classmates freaking out because a tiny bee was collecting pollen. Other than that, Tower Hill was a legendary field trip. First grade was my first year playing on the big kid playground. I kept falling off the spider web, but I wasn't the only one. First grade was definitely different than kindergarten, but it was fun and educational. Yay, spectacular second grade. I had my favorite year and teacher, Lofty Lebarski. She was so nice. She taught me science like simple machines. She also taught us to read bigger books and add or subtract 3 or 4-digit numbers. I also remember writing books like Marvin the Guinea Pig, The Famous Weekend, and Zoo Trouble. That was based off of the best field trip ever. It was at Southwest Zoo, and even though it was raining, that didn't ruin it. We saw monkeys, alligators, peacocks, and pigs. It was very fun. Second grade was like kindergarten all over again, except we learned different things. Thrilling third grade. It would be my favorite year, but it was the first year of homework due daily in MCAS. My teacher was Mrs. Kelleher, and she was funny. She liked lobsters, I liked lobsters, she liked the chocolate, and I also liked chocolate. We had a lot in common. She taught us fractions, multiplication, division, and how to write persuasive stories. Our field trip was at Old Sturbridge Village, and it was great. We spent the longest time at the gift shop, and I got candy and a fake Declaration of Independence. It was a fun year. Flattering fourth grade was great. My teacher was Mrs. Koziak. We learned hard math and the states and capitals. Our field trip was at the Boston Museum of Science, and that was fun. We saw many cool exhibits, and my favorite part was the human body room because we got to touch a dead sheep. The fourth grade field trips were fun too. My favorites were the Invention Convention, the Stay Floats, and the Marshmallow Catapult. I made it third place. Fourth grade was a great warm-up to fifth grade. Yes, fabulous fifth grade. I had an awesome teacher, Ms. Kirsten, and she was awesome. Because she had us read Bridge to Terabithia, But Not Buddy, Mrs. Frisbee and the Rasm Nim, and Island of the Ludolphins. They were also interesting. We also had the homework club, and that was when our photos are on a board, and if we forget our homework, our face gets off the board. If your face is still on by the end of the month, she makes you dessert. Luckily, she's a really good cook. We learned social studies, a lot of harder math, science, Mr. Andrews. He was great and I learned so much from him. I loved the fun but kind of dangerous experiments. Our field trips were at the Mystic Seaport in Boston. They both were super fun. Fifth grade was awesome and no grade will be as fun as fifth grade was. BES is the best school ever. Each grade was different but exotic, and there's a fun detail in each one. How will Tohonto ever compare? Only time will tell. Watch out, Tohonto, here I come.